So you want to 3D print a part that's too large for your printer? Then you'll need to break it up into smaller parts and find the best way to combine them into one solid piece. Today I'll show you a few different methods and test which ones have the strongest bonds. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. This helmet was printed as one solid piece, and this one was done as 11 smaller pieces, and it's just as sturdy. Before combining the parts, I wanted to find the best method to do this without worrying about cracking or breaking. Today I'll show you a few different methods and then test out each one, then use the best one to combine the smaller parts into one solid helmet or whatever large prints you might be working on. Let's get started. I made 4 sets of test prints to try out each method. The first method is just to glue the parts together. This Gorilla Super Glue Gel is normally what I use on my prints. I taped the 2 halves together to hold them in place. Now I'm applying a bunch of glue dots all the way across the seam. Then hold it together with the tape while it cures. For the second method, I will bond the pieces together using friction welding. Friction welding is done with a Dremel or other rotary tool. First, you need to print some of these nubs or bits or whatever you want to call them. The files are available on printables and were made by Uncle Jesse. Since they're small, it's a good way to finish off your rolls of leftover filament. I pre-taped the parts together to hold them in place. First, you take all the bits and parts off the Dremel, then attach the nub on the end. And just in case, I'll put on some safety glasses. Then plug it in and start welding. It's melting the 2 parts as well as the PLA from the nub. I think this will make a strong bond. But it is also more difficult to control with the Dremel spinning so fast. You can see the bit get smaller as it melts the plastic, so you want to make sure you have plenty of extra pieces for a large print. Be sure to use a respirator for this next method. I will be melting the parts together using the soldering iron. You don't want to be breathing in the smoke from the melting plastic. And again, I have the parts taped to hold them together. This way seems much easier than using the Dremel. It's quick to apply and I feel like I have more control. Just move the soldering iron back and forth along the seam to melt the parts together. You can also use an extra piece of filament and melt it if you need to add more material. I used a blue filament so you can see where it is compared to the black and gray halves. And the fourth method is to use a 3D pen. I don't normally use a 3D pen, so I just borrowed my daughter's to try this out. I was expecting red to come out, but it looks like there was plenty of yellow left in the pen. The filament from the pen is easy to apply, but it's not melting the parts like the last 2 methods, so I'm not sure how well this is going to hold. Before I test the strength of the bonds, I want to show you each of these up close. The first one, there's not really much to see, just 2 parts glued together. And the second one is the friction weld. You can see the gray and black and the green from the nubs all melted together. The third one is the soldering iron. This one looks much cleaner and you can see how the 2 sides are melted together. And the last one is the 3D pen. It's held together, but it seems the sides are just held to the yellow from the pen instead of each other. Now let's see how well these hold together. I set up a simple test with things I had laying around, and I got a cheap luggage scale. One half of the print is screwed down, and the other half is hanging over with the scale attached. The first test is with the super glue. Let's see how many pounds I can apply before it breaks. In slow motion, you can see that it broke off at 9 pounds. Alright, here it is up close. It was a pretty clean break at 9 pounds. I rate the bond strength a 4 out of 10. The second test is the friction weld. After 35 pounds, I give it one more shot. I can't even get this one to break. So for this one, I give it a 10 out of 10 for strength. It was 45 pounds and no issues at all. I think it was obvious I was struggling, so for strength, I gave myself a 5, maybe a 4. I don't know. Let's go on to the next one. The third test is the soldering iron. Let's see what happens here. I think we need to look at that one closer. Let's go back. You can see that it actually didn't break at the seam. It actually broke where the screws were holding the part in place. This one was still holding at 35 pounds, so I give it at least a 9 out of 10 for strength. And the last one is the 3D pin. The reflection blocked the dial, so you'll just have to take my word that it broke at 0, maybe 1 pound. So I give this one a 1 out of 10. It doesn't really bond to the plastic. It comes right off. Before putting the helmet together, let's look at the pros and cons of each of these methods. Method 1 is a super glue gel. The pros are that it has the cleanest look and it has a bigger variety of uses. You don't need to worry about applying it just on areas that won't be seen on the final print. And the main con is that it's a consumable. You'll go through the glue pretty quickly with larger prints. And for the strength, I rated it a 4 out of 10. The second method is friction welding. For the pros, it was definitely the strongest bond, plus it bonds instantly. For the cons, it was a little more difficult to control, plus you need to keep printing more of the bits. Strength was at a 10 out of 10. Method 3 was the soldering iron. For the pros, it was very easy to apply, plus it's an instant bond. For the con, you have the smoke coming from the burning plastic, which is why I recommended a respirator. I gave this one at least a 9 out of 10 for strength. And the last method was the 3D pin. For the pro, I'd have to say there's other uses for this. I've used the 3D pen before when a support broke on a very long print. And the con, it was definitely the weakest bond. Strength was a 1 out of 10. For the helmet, I'm deciding to go with the soldering iron. You may decide to go with a different method depending on what tools you have. Like if you have a Dremel, you could always go with the friction welding. Or if you just have a 3D pen, then go buy a soldering iron and do that instead. Okay, let's get started on this helmet. I start by taping the first two parts together. It's important to make sure that the parts are lined up perfectly and stay together as you solder them. I start by melting a couple spots on each seam, kind of like a couple of stitches. This way I can check to make sure that they are aligned. If they aren't, at this point I can still heat up those couple spots and reposition the part. Now I drag the soldering iron back and forth across the seam so the sides melt into each other. Here are the seams up close so you can see how they look. Next part is the top of the helmet. I start again by taping the parts together to keep them aligned, and I'll do the same thing for all the parts moving forward. I'm starting here and working my way out to make sure I have good access to the seams. If I did the top last, it would be more difficult to reach inside the helmet and be more difficult to see what I'm doing. The finished part will be very solid once all the inside seams are melted together. For the outside of the seams, you can fill them in using Bondo Spot Putty. I put an affiliate link in the description for that, as well as other tools or materials mentioned in this video. And that's all there is to it. As long as you make sure the parts are positioned correctly and taped together, this is a very easy process. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like it, and check this out next. Oh, sorry, I missed. Thank you for watching.